What is ESO? Even if you've not yet heard of us, you have most certainly seen us.
An object from interstellar space.
Nothing else in our solar system looks like this.
Será el telescopio más grande del planeta y se está construyendo aquí en nuestro país.
We are ESO, the European Southern Observatory, and for decades we've been designing, building, and operating the most advanced ground-based telescopes in the world.
We're developing very, very challenging projects that no one else in humankind has ever done.
There are people who build a bridge, they go to the seaside or to the mountain. We are building the highway towards knowledge.
I think what's special about ESO is the level of international cooperation that's really enabled astronomers to study all sorts of different phenomena in the universe.
Here, astronomers took the first direct image of a planet outside of our solar system. Here, they established that the universe is expanding ever faster. Here, they found that there's a supermassive black hole lurking at the center of our galaxy. And thanks to a worldwide collaboration, we know what it looks like.
And now we're getting our first image
of a supermassive black hole
in our galaxy, the Milky Way.
Here is in Chile. ESO operates its three observing sites in the Atacama Desert and is proud to have access to one of the world's best locations for astronomy.
I never thought I will be part of the discovering of the universe. It sounds big because it is, you know, it's crazy.
You know, I've been tens of times in Paranal. I enjoy every single sunset.
We're a partner in ALMA, the most sensitive array telescope in the world.
I've never encountered such a nice, warm set of people as are at the site here at ALMA. And I just love the action that takes place in daily operations here.
Being in places like ALMA or Paranal or La Silla, I haven't met anyone that has visited and then just went on with their lives. You're gonna get some new perspectives.
You're in the order of almost 2 years which I spent in Chile. I never regretted a single moment.
At ESO, we build bridges between countries. Chile, our member states, and strategic partners, and our many collaborators in industry and academia. And we build bridges between science and society. We educate and inspire. We generate business opportunities, stimulate development, and train the next generation of astronomers and engineers. Our headquarters are in Germany. This is our administrative and engineering hub, where much of the telescope design and development takes place. Our engineers, together with many partners and experts from industry and academia, have been advancing technology for over 60 years. Since building our first telescopes, we've increased their mirror size from 1 meter to 3 meters to the 4 8-meter telescopes of our flagship, the Very Large Telescope. We've built deformable mirrors. We have lasers. Now we're building a telescope that will bring about a new era for astronomy, the extremely large telescope, a giant with a main mirror of nearly 40 meters. Okay, the name might not be very inventive, but to build the ELT, we need to be.
It's an enormous project. It's a monster. I mean, it's, you know, deep down that you will never get to see another project like this in your lifetime.
We only build prototypes. So we're breaking new territory every single day here. And this is amazing for a scientist, for an engineer, for an administrator that supports this.
To me, it's about being in this constant state of reminding myself that there is still a lot to learn. And that there is no better place to be learning new things as it is here. This is exciting. This is a big motivator.
We are solving puzzles, such as, how can you move thousands of tons with precision finer than the thickness of a human hair? How can you make 800 separate mirrors behave as if they were one? And how can you build all this to withstand a strong earthquake? Together, we push the limits of what is technologically possible.
We're doing this for a purpose, because it's the very most powerful scientific tool in ground-based astronomy for the next two decades. It will poke into corners that we can't even anticipate today.
We are certain to find things that we haven't thought of before. It's been true of every telescope that's ever been commissioned. So I'm really looking forward to being surprised.
For my daughters, my grandson, and for many little people today, they will know more thanks to this machine.
So, do we have all the answers?
No, definitely not. But that's part of the excitement. I'm an astronomer here at ESO, and for me, the excitement is about figuring out if there could be planets out there that have an atmosphere similar to the one we breathe here on the Earth. And of course, finding the answer to the ultimate question. Are we alone, or could there be life out there in the universe?
One thing is for certain, staying curious and searching for answers as we do here at ESO never gets boring. Join us on this journey.